Hello, I'm continuing my reviews on the Child's Play series with Curse of Chucky. Now, Curse of Chucky is the sixth and so far the final film in the Child's Play series. Now, this came out this year. It came out in 2013, and it went straight to DVD and Blu-ray when it came out. Now, the film is written and directed by Don Mancini, who co-wrote the first Child's Play movie, and he wrote Child's Play 2, Child's Play 3, Bride of Chucky, and he wrote and directed Seed of Chucky. Now, when I first saw the trailer for this movie, I have to admit, the trailer did not really sell me very well, but I started to hear some pretty positive things about the movie, so I decided to check it out, and also, I was interested in seeing it because I am, in general, a fan of the Child's Play series. Even though I hated Seed of Chucky, I still was interested in seeing it because it is a new addition to this series, which, in general, I am a fan of. So, eventually, I got the movie on DVD, and me and my friend watched it, and I have to say that I enjoyed the film. However, I don't think this movie was perfect. Now, I noticed that this movie has been getting a lot of mixed reactions from people. Like, some people really seem to love it, and some people really seem to hate it. Now, I watched this movie with my friend, and my friend really did not like the movie, but I personally enjoyed the film. However, I could see why my friend didn't like it. And I saw one review on the movie where the guy said that he thought this was the best Child's Play movie since the first one, and I'm going to have to respectfully disagree with that. I do not think this is the best Child's Play movie since the first one. However, there is a lot that I do appreciate about this movie. Now, my main problem with the movie is really the characters. Like, besides the main character, like the lead girl in the movie, none of the other characters were really that memorable to me. I don't want to say, like, they're unlikable characters, because in the case of some of them, they're actually meant to be unlikable characters, but I just found a lot of the characters, with the exception of the lead girl in the movie, I found a lot of them to be really forgettable, but that's just my opinion. Other people might feel more of a connection to these characters. It's just, me personally, they didn't really do anything for me, with the exception of the lead character in the movie. Now, the lead character in the movie is actually played by Fiona Dourif, who is actually the daughter of Brad Dourif, who plays the voice of Chucky. So the plot of Curse of Chucky is it's about a wheelchair-bound young woman named Mika who, in the beginning of the movie, is living with her mother at this mansion, and what happens is they get a package in the mail, and they open it, and it's a good guy doll. Now, we as the audience realize that it's Chucky. Now, they don't know who sent this package, so they don't know if it was sent there by accident or if it's some kind of joke, but they end up throwing the doll out, and that night, Nika's mother ends up getting killed. Now, Nika thinks that her mother may have killed herself because you find out in the movie that her mother may have been unstable, but of course we as the audience could pretty much already figure out who it was who killed Nika's mother, but what happens is Nika's sister and her brother-in-law and her niece and their nanny and this priest who is a friend of the family ends up coming over after they find out what happened to Nika's mother, and what happens is, long story short, Nika's niece ends up finding Chucky, and she ends up being the first one to really find out that Chucky is alive, and Chucky starts pretending to be her friend, and long story short, throughout the movie, you have Chucky killing off each of the members of this family one by one, and that's the basic plot line of Curse of Chucky. Now, I enjoyed Curse of Chucky for the most part. Like, as I said before, my main problem with the movie is really besides the character of Nika, I didn't really, like, care for the other characters. Like, I found the other characters to be kind of forgettable. Even the little girl, like, honestly, I thought they could have used that character a little bit more, and I felt like the character of the little girl who is the one who Chucky pretends to be friends with, like, I felt like they really underused that character, and really she's not even in the movie very much. Like, you know, really the main focus of the movie is really the conflict between Chucky and Nika, but, you know, I don't know, I didn't think the movie was perfect, but there is a lot that I do appreciate about this movie. Like, one thing I really like about the movie is they really do make reference to the earlier Child's Play movies. Like, they do make reference to Andy Barkley quite a bit throughout the movie, and, you know, and also in the movie you get flashbacks to before Charles Lee Ray transferred his soul into the good guy doll, and you find out that there is actually a connection between Charles Lee Ray and this family that Chucky is terrorizing. So, you know, I thought that was interesting, but at the same time, during those flashback sequences, you get Brad Dourif reprising his role as Charles Lee Ray, and Brad Dourif is obviously much older now than he was when he played Charles Lee Ray in the first one. So, when you get those flashbacks, you have Brad Dourif looking much older than the character of Charles Lee Ray was supposed to be during the time those flashbacks in the movie take place. So, I thought that was a little awkward, but, besides that, I mean, I liked how they did that, though. But at the same time, when you find out what the connection between this family and Chucky actually is, like, when you find out what Charles Lee Ray did to this family, like, it just, to me, seems almost a little out of character for Chucky. I mean, maybe I'm the only one who notices that, but to me personally, it just seemed a little almost out of character for Chucky, and you'll probably understand if you see the movie, but, you know, like, I don't think it's a flawless movie, but there are some things about the movie that I do like. Now, when I first heard about this movie, I heard that it was going to be picking up where Child's Play 3 left off, and it was going to ignore the continuity of Bride and Seed of Chucky, but that's not actually the case, because Tiffany actually does make an appearance in this movie, and her appearance in this movie actually does kind of tie into the end of Seed of Chucky. So according to this movie, Bride and Seed of Chucky are still technically considered to be canon. But of course, this movie is much more serious than Bride and Seed of Chucky was, and, also, Andy Barkley does show up in this movie as well, and the scene where Andy Barkley shows up is probably my favorite scene in the whole movie. And honestly, though, when Andy Barkley does show up in this movie, it kind of made me wish that the whole movie was centered around Andy Barkley. Even though I thought the character of Nika was a pretty likable character, I personally would have rather have seen a movie really about Andy Barkley all these years later, but that's just me. One thing I do want to point out, though, is this movie does have kind of a downbeat ending. Like, something happens to the main character of the movie, which I really didn't think she deserved that, and it has a really downbeat ending, which I'm really not sure what I think of that, because I really didn't think that character deserved that to happen to her, and if you see the movie, you probably know what I'm talking about. But, overall, Curse of Chucky, it's not really a great movie, but I do like the film a lot. I do appreciate what it was trying to do. Like, I appreciate what Don Mancini was trying to do. So, yeah, that's my review on Curse of Chucky. If you're a fan of the Child's Play films, I would definitely recommend checking this movie out at least once. And bye.